only three things that can kill a farmer. Lightning, rolling over in a tractor, and old age. A quote by the humorous Bill Bryson. Slightly morbid, yes, but there is a point to this. Before that lightning strikes, that tractor rolls, and old age takes its toll, Canada needs to secure its next generation of farmers. Good evening, honorable judges, fellow speakers, and members of the audience. Who will be Canada's next generation of farmers? I was supposed to be. And like many members of my generation, we don't know if we're going to return to the family business, while others have run screaming in the other direction. So, with the average age of farmers getting older, and less new farmers entering the industry, who is going to cultivate the fruits of tomorrow within Canada? Tonight, I'm going to talk to you about the next generation of Canadian farmers. Now, I don't know them by name or which towns they come from, but what I can tell you is who they're going to be as a person, as a leader, and as a member of one of the most significant industries leading this nation. Who's going to be the next generation of farmers? Think to yourselves, who's going to take over the family farm if not the farmer's children? Who's going to fill the stands at the local farmer's market with that produce that you love and trust? Let's first think, why would someone work in the ag industry? Benjamin Franklin once said, there seems to be three ways for a nation to acquire wealth. The first is by war, which is robbery. The second is by commerce, which is generally cheating. And the third is by agriculture. The only honest way wherein man receives a real increase from the seed thrown into the ground in a kind of continual miracle as a reward for his innocent life and his virtuous industry. So that still leaves the question, though. Who is going to be the laborers of this industry? Well, we can look at trends. Bigger farms, less people, and more dependent on technology. So should I be so bold to say that the next generation isn't going to be people at all? But are robotic milkers and tractors controlled from satellites in space? No, I'm not going to say that. Historically, the farmers and the laborers of this industry have been farming immigrants and their children. However, in the last 40 years, Canada has seen a reduction of their farming immigrants by two-thirds. We can look at family farm succession. But Canada has lost 7% of their family farms within just 5 years. We can also look at people engaging in urban agriculture. But they're not producing enough to feed the whole city. And this is the important point, that it's not just one of these groups alone, but collectively, as farmers of Canada, will they feed people here at home and around the world. It will be a diverse group, with different backgrounds, bringing in new knowledge into the industry. And true, there will be fewer of them. But with innovations in business and technology, we will see them thrive, flourish, and exceed the expectations of the generations heading out the door. Now, this won't be easy. The next generation is going to have to be passionate, enthusiastic, and above all else, optimistic. Because the next generation is going to be facing increasing challenges, such as access to capital and farm assets, especially without receiving a high debt load. And let's not forget to mention the growing environmental concerns, such as soil erosion, water contamination, and lack of biodiversity. Who's going to be the next generation of Canadian farmers? Who is going to want to deal with all that? Well, they're not going to be just farmers. They're going to be problem solvers. They're going to be men and women with MBAs seeking unique business models. They will succeed through farm diversification and farmer-driven value-added agriculture. Farmers will own the processing facilities to make us, the consumers, our favorite Canadian cheeses, butter, bread, meats, and the possibilities are endless, and I can't wait for it all. The next generation isn't going to just feed cities. They're going to develop communities. Our next generation is going to be engaged in corporate responsibility to help improve the quality of air, water, food, and the standard of living of communities all around the world. These farms will gain great reputations, and consumers will learn to appreciate and respect the farms that they buy their food from. And imagine that, these farms leading the industry. The face of Canadian agriculture is changing. Who is the next generation of Canadian farmers? They're resilient farmers. These farmers are learning to adapt, to use resources that were once thought of as waste. Farms do not produce waste, but opportunities. And you can see this through the increasing use of biofuels, methane digesters, solar panels and windmills. And this is just the beginning. Solutions to many of the world's problems, I believe, are going to come from the farmer. Like I said earlier, I cannot give you a name. I can't give you an age, a gender, or any GPS location telling you where they're going to come from. Because who a person is much deeper than that. So who will they be? The message is that the next generation of farmers are going to be diverse. They're not going to be just that farmer you're used to seeing in the field. They're going to be business leaders. They're going to be urban dwellers. They're going to be passionate environmentalists. They're going to be corporate leaders, and they're going to be community leaders. They're going to be, as Benjamin Franklin said, the people making the living the honest way. And they're going to be darn good at it too. I'm Martin Straathof, and I thank you once again for taking the time to listen.